I just finished cutting out this junk journal on my Cameo 5, and I thought I might as well share how I created the template with you guys. I went through and used a lot of the tools that are not very well known in Silhouette Studio, so if you've been looking for something new to try out in the software, you might just want to stick around. Hi, I'm Brenda Lambert. I'm a TJC licensed instructor for Silhouette. You found your way to Silhouette success, and I do hope that you're going to join our little community. We would absolutely love to have you. Now, in this video, I use a lot of the tools. We work with the drawing tools, the shapes, and the lines. We create scoring lines that you can make with your embossing tool on your newer Silhouettes, and some hidden features in the align tools that you may not even know are there. Now, if everyone's ready to learn something new, let's do this. We are going to start with a simple square. So let's grab our rectangle from the drawing tools, hold down our shift key and pull that out. We want this to be exactly 12 inches. We can lock our aspect ratio button here and type in 12 and hit enter. Now, since we are working on a very precise design here, we're going to go ahead and select center to the page so that we know everything is going to be lined up perfectly. Next, we're going to work on some score lines. So let's grab a line from the drawing tools, hold down our shift key so that it's perfectly straight, and pull that down. Now, in order to size your lines, you want to unlock the aspect ratio and then type in your number. Again, I'm going with 12. Since the lines are going to be scored, I am going to change this color to blue. Now our cut lines will be in red and our score lines will be in blue. And we will need quite a few of these, so I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this before I place it. And then I am going to center that to the page as well. Now this blue line is in the center of the page, but it's also in the center of this square. We are going to be using these two lines to create a spine for our junk journal. So we don't really need this in the center of the page. We want the spine to be a quarter of an inch wide. So let's come up here to this double arrow. We're going to adjust this distance to 0.125, and then we are going to click the left arrow and it will bump it over 0.125 inches to the left. Now we can select this line, let's duplicate it, center that to the page, go back to our distance here, and we are going to click this one over to the right at 0.125 inches. Now these two score lines will create a quarter of an inch spine on our junk journal. Let's go ahead and duplicate this again. Pull this over to the side, and you want your smart snapping enabled for this. You can see when I get it lined up just right, there's a blue line on the side and there's a blue line at the top telling me it's exactly where it needs to be. Since this is still selected, we can come up to our distance again, and this time we're going to bump this number up to 0.5, and we're going to bump that over to the right. Let's select this one and duplicate it. Bring this all the way over to the other side and line it up again. Go to our distance, and we're going to bump that to the left a half inch. Now we've created all of the vertical lines we need. Let's select this line, go over to the transform panel, open up the rotate tab and rotate this by 90 degrees, and this will give us some horizontal lines. We'll start off by duplicating it, and we can bring this right up to the top. Once it's aligned, we can go up to our distance and we are going to bump that down by a half inch. Duplicate this one again, bring this one all the way down to the bottom and bump that up by a half inch. Now for our last one, we want to line this up exactly with the one we just placed. Go up to our distance, and we want to bring this up by 2 1/4 inches. So adjust this with the arrows and then click up. And now we have all of our score lines set in place. The next thing we want to do is make the holes for our binding. Let's grab an ellipse, hold down our shift key and draw a very small circle. The line is in red, which is what we want because we are going to cut these out, but I am going to switch the fill color up so we can see them a little bit better. We will need 3 circles. Let's duplicate that twice and let's center this to the page to start with.
so we know it's right in the middle of our spine. I'm using my arrow key to pull it down to about the spot where I want it. Now I can bring another one up to the top, and you can see because I have my smart snapping enabled, that blue line lights up and lets me know that it is in the middle where I need it. Now I can grab this third one, place it anywhere in the middle of these two, get it lined up. Now we can select all three of the dots by holding down our shift key. We can go up to our align tool at the top and click this one, and it is going to space all three dots evenly. And now that they are set where we want them, we can group them together so that they don't get knocked out of place in all of this. Now, in order to make the cover for our junk journal, we need to be able to fold all of these sections over and glue them down to the inside of the page. But first, we need to kind of slice these corners off so that all of this part doesn't get in the way of our gluing. We can do this by double-clicking on our white square to bring up the editing points. And let's zoom in on this corner. And we are going to use our ruler at the top and over on the side for precision. We're going to come over and place an editing point at the 1-inch mark. We're going to come over to the side and do the same thing over here. And we can grab this editing point that's in the corner and pull it down to the spot where those two score lines meet. Now, at this point, you can tidy up your score lines. It isn't completely necessary, but it does look better and it saves a little bit of time with the scoring. So double click on the blue line to bring up your editing points and then click on that point. You can use the arrow key on your keyboard just to pull it over so that it meets up with the red line. Click on the other score line. That'll bring up this editing point. Click on that so that it's white. And then use your down arrow key. You don't really want to be moving the editing points around with your mouse pad too much because you want to make sure that everything stays perpendicular. So now we've cut this corner down and we've adjusted our score lines. Let's fit back to the window. And you can see now that this corner will be able to be folded over and none of this is going to overlap. Let's move on to this area. You can zoom in. This is a little bit different because we need to cut out this part of the spine. Let's bring up the editing points. There are none here, but we are going to create some. We want one right at this score line, and we want one right at this score line. Now, when you hover over this point, you can see on the top ruler that it's kind of an odd measurement. It's at 1/8 of an inch. So if we bump over to the middle of these two, that is 1/4 of an inch, and we can go into the middle of these two, and that is 1/2 an inch, and that is where we want our new editing point. So let's click there on the line and do the same for over here. It's right at the 1/8 of an inch mark. Let's move over 1/4 inch and another 1/4 inch. That'll give us the 1/2 inch that we're looking for, and we can place an editing point there. Now we're going to select this editing point that is on the spine, and we are going to use the down arrow key to bring it down to the blue score line. We can select this one here and do the same. And now we can adjust our score lines with the arrow keys as well. Now we're able to fold this flap over completely. Let's go ahead and work on this side. Bottom a little bit differently because this area and this area is going to fold up to create pockets on the inside of our junk journal cover. We want to cut away at an angle here and an angle here for the inside pockets. So let's zoom in a bit. It's a bit much. Let's zoom out. There we go. The first thing we're going to do is start with editing points at our score lines. So let's make one here and one here. Then we are going to come over to the 4-inch mark and make an editing point here. And then we're going to go over to the 8-inch mark and make a point here. Now let's select this editing point and use our up arrow key to bring it all the way up to the second point where the score lines cross. Select the second editing point and do the same thing. Now we can adjust these two score lines in the same way that we have been. Just click on the end point and hold your up arrow key until it meets the end point up there. Now this line is solid, and even if we put an editing point in here, it really wouldn't do us any good. We need to break this line apart. The easiest way to do this is with the knife tool. You can also use the eraser tool, or you can create an editing point and break the path. But we are just going to use the knife tool and just drag the knife over that. It doesn't have to be straight or anything. Now you can select this point and drag it over with your arrow key, and you can see that we have effectively split the line in two. We can pull the one editing point over to this side, and we can select this editing point and pull it over to the other side. Now that we have everything set up exactly the way we want it, we want to select all of our score lines. So let's do select by color and click on blue, right click and group. Let's select all of the cut lines, right click and group. That brought the cut lines to the front. You can no longer see the score lines. So let's right click on this and send it to the back. Now we want to select our red lines and our blue lines together. Let's group them so we can get the scale down. We want everything to fit right inside of the cut lines. So let's open up our page setup panel and show the cut border. You can scale the whole thing down just a bit. Click on center to page. And I think that's still a little bit large. We can zoom and see that all of the cut lines are definitely inside of the cut border, so we're good to go there. We can go up to the send panel, and right now everything is set to cut. That is not what we want, so let's right click and ungroup. We're going to leave our red cut lines set to cut. We're going to select our score lines and set them to emboss. And we can create all of these score lines with our embossing tool. And if you do not have the embossing tools, you can change these to dashed lines and do the perforated scores. If you are doing the perforated score lines, you will need to keep these set to cut as well. So now the red lines are set to cut. I'm going to choose cardstock textured heavy for that setting. And on my carriage 2, I'm going to choose score and emboss paper. Now this is set to auto emboss. My embossing tool is detected and it comes up with the force and speed and passes. So now all of our settings should be correct and this can be sent through to cut. This is fine just like this for the outside cover. But when you get into making the pages for inside of your book, the score line is going to come right down the center instead of one on each side. So if it cuts these holes out first and then scores, it's going to tear the paper and probably get stuck, and we don't want that. So when we're doing the inside pages, we will select the cut lines and set them to no cut, and then we will do the scoring first. We will leave our mat loaded in the machine, come back to the software, then we will set this to no emboss, then we will select our cut lines and change that to cut. But that's only for the inside pages. Now I'm going to run through and create the rest of the inside pages and pockets and frames and all of the other goodies that go with this template. But while I do that, I wanted to let you know that I have opened up subscriptions for the channel. When you join, you are going to become a Silhouette Sidekick, and you will get your badges and personalized emojis and shout outs on the channel, bunch of good stuff, and more to come. This is an excellent way to support the channel to allow me to keep creating content at this pace. Subscriptions run $2.99 a month, and to kick things off, I'm going to put a link in the community tab to this template so that you can create junk journals with your silhouette as well.